like so many of you guys, I woke up this morning with just thought it was a bad dream. As a teammate, he was the best teammate you can have. He would run through the walls for you. Got every ounce out of his talent that was humanly possible. Just remember him chasing down somebody, just got to steal, chasing down, blocking a shot. Coming up, flying through the air on a missed shot of mine, probably from three. Finishing one of those patented two-hand dunks. And the joy and the smile where he embraced life. Where he touched people. Anybody who came across Jerome just was amazed. We had many talks about coming from those small schools and talking about how we'd show all those guys from the big schools what coming from a small school is all about with our effort and energy and giving everything we could, but you know, Blazer Nation is in serious pain today, and our heart goes out to Terry, Kiara, and the rest of the Kersey family as we go through this very difficult time. Too soon. All the good ones go too soon. Got a hold of Clyde and Buck and talked about that starting five and talked about how much Jerome meant, all the tangible things he did for us. And just what he did for this community, how this community embraced that team has grown and made us all sons almost, and just makes it special. Truly makes it special. He will be missed. He will be missed by the Blazers, but the NBA, the brotherhood of NBA, anybody who, all the many stops he had, you ask anybody who ever played with him, they loved playing with him. Love what he, energy and the physicality and the way he played. Just guys just fed off that.
Check you out. And then he got in my face and began to shout.
Bust the bucket, hold it, Dr. Blazer, do these super songs, slamming G's and killer freezing, go up, get it, got it good.
Bust. Oh, this is gonna be harder than I thought. How you spelling that?
Bust the bucket, hold it, Dr. Blazer, do these super songs, slamming G's and killer freezing, go up, get it, got it good.
Bust. Yeah, great, whatever. Back to my story.
Bob Costa's ringing, next thing I know, man, Kersey's singing.
Ooh, baby, you got the touch. Take it easy, man, you're working too much. Future big, don't you say?
Bump on your head. travel up and down the court, just like I'm the king on the microphone. So it's Dr. J and Moses Malone. I like slam dunks and taking it to the hoop. My favorite play is the alley oop. I like the pick and roll, I like the give and go, cause it's basketball, but Mr. Curtis flow. Earl the Pearl and Will Big O and Jerry West play basketball at its very best. Basketball has always been my thing. I like Magic Bird and Bernard Kane. And number 33, my man Kareem is the center on my stalling team.
I think our team was a special team this year. I think we had guys who really had one common goal, and that's to play together and do the best you can as a team. And when we were clicking, I think we could do some very good things.
Drexler. Score! Oh, my!
Drexler gonna drive, clear out, over the hoop, put it up, one! Buckley, the rebound, back to Porter!
A team that fanned the flames of Blazer Mania into an inferno that rocked the entire state of Oregon. A team with more W's in the win column, contributing to their bitter season in franchise history, started with a celebration of the previous season's success. But there would be no resting on Larkin. NBA experts across the country had Portland listed as one of the favorites in the NBA.
You know, I've been through the season where you walk out there and you wonder if you're going to get it done tonight. And now it's like, you know, if we don't go out and beat ourselves, then we expect to win every game.
When we go on the floor now, that's kind of how I feel, and I look at our team that, you know, we expect to win. We don't expect to lose it no matter where we play. And that's a good feeling.
You're right, Terry. Too soon. 52 years of age. And it happened so quick. I was with Jerome. I've spent a lot of time with Jerome over the years, but since he's been in our office, I see him every day, as Chris said a few moments ago. Saw him yesterday morning. He had a knee operation, minor knee operation on Friday, and he thought he was going to be on crutches for the weekend. And he didn't have the crutches yesterday. I gave him a bad time about that. He said, "No, I don't need the crutches. I'm going to be okay." We kibitzed around for a while, and he had something to do in the afternoon, and I had something to do. And his last words to me yesterday morning, "Johns, have a good day." I had a good day for a while. Then we got the news. I've been asked about Mercy Jerome Kersey in the last few hours, how that started. Terry alluded to how he played with his teammates. He never got all the accolades that some of the other players did, but he was a very integral part of that team, day in and day out. I think it was against Chicago that particular year, 1990, or maybe it was 89. Long time ago, anyway. And typical Terry, or Jerome Knight, I think it was Terry that passed him the ball. And of course, you knew how fast and how hard he ran. He got the ball, dribbled a couple of times, and he went in a two-hander. He stuffed that baby, and right then I said, mercy, mercy, Jerome, cursing. And it stuck. And wherever he went, and I was with him a lot, mercy, mercy, mercy. Our prayers go out to Terry, the family, all the people that know him. They need your prayers, that's for sure. He is going to be missed dearly. But I know he's going to go down as maybe the most popular all-time player that we've had in this franchise. He endeared himself to the fans of the Pacific Northwest, the great state of Oregon, and around the country, and basketball people knew what he could do to help. He always had a kind word for everybody. He loved to talk to kids. He knew how to talk to them. He always had a smile on his face. A lot of times, you couldn't shut him up. But he kept right on going. And that was Jerome Kersey. I don't know what more to say. Most of us in this room have known him for a long time. I knew he was special when he first came to us, as Harry Glickman explained, and how he got here from that small college back east. You could tell right then and there he was going to be a big help. And by golly, he was. He was my friend. He was my buddy. And I'll never forget him. Thank you.